The Cyclones look to push their winning streak to 6 games as they wrap up a 4-game homestand. Everett Fitzhugh back here for Cyclones TV. It is game day. The Clones wrapping up morning skate ahead of tonight's contest against the Wichita Thunder. Cyclones picked up a 5-4 overtime victory over the Thunder back on Saturday night. Head coach Matt Macdonald reflects on Cincy's come-from-behind win.
Yeah, no, it was a tight game. I felt like we had our chances. Both teams had good chances, and it was a tight game, and it's a good team to be going against. And obviously, they got a lot of firepower there, so we got to be able to manage our game properly, especially with the puck and getting in. You know, the little things, little details, have to be on point here moving forward. I felt like for the most part of that game, we were pretty good, but there were still some deficiencies there that we needed our goalie to bail us out on, which, you know, that can't be a solid game we play. We got to make sure that we're better defensively, especially against this team and moving forward. Well, there's a lot of positives to take out of it for sure. I thought, as once we got into that game and we got going, it was we took control of it at times, but, the start still got to be better. First 10 minutes of a period, especially the start of a game. The power play is doing well. The PK did really well. They're 3-for-3. I'm starting to see that raise its tempo a bit and start getting more success on that side of it, almost getting a shorthanded goal with Danforth and some good things that way. And I felt like for the most part, our faceoffs were pretty good as well. Obviously, some individual efforts with Begenda and Schultz and guys and Danforth and Nodal and all the big guys stepping up. But there's a lot of guys that went unnoticed there that were blocking shots. You know, Robbie McNally, you know, Winston Daychief, guys like that, Zombo, these guys that play hard every night and they maybe don't have anything on the score sheet at times, but they're a big part of this team. And all around, it was a good effort, but we need to be better coming into tonight.
Saturday was a big night for Cyclones forward Jesse Schultz as he notched his 800th professional point. He looks back on his long career and reflects on that milestone and takes us into what he's thinking heading into his 900th professional game.
Kind of every day that goes by after it happened, I kind of think about it a little bit more and kind of sinks in. It means I played a long time, played with a lot of good teams, played with a lot of good players. I mean, you don't get that many points without playing with good players, so... It's been a lot of fun, and it was a cool night on Saturday for sure. Obviously, I think the championships are higher because they're a team thing, and you go through so much together as a team, and to finally win it at the end is really special. But for individual accomplishments, it's definitely high up there. I'm proud of it. I think I'll when I'm all done playing, I think I'll look back and be a little bit more special just to think back on it and realize how cool it was. Yeah, that's I'm thinking about all the money I have to put on the board. That's what's coming up, all the milestones. But it's kind of cool. I think you get that towards the end of your career. You come to some milestones and they're neat. Like I said, it just means I've been around a while, been fortunate to stay healthy too is another thing that I kind of goes unnoticed. I don't know if maybe it's a style of my play or whatever, but been healthy for the most of my career, which leads to playing a lot of games.
No, it's great. I think he was pretty excited to get that over with, and obviously 800 points is something pretty special. Not a lot of guys can put their hat on, and he's a big part of our team. He's a leader in that room and on and off the ice. He's a guy that's got a lot of experience, obviously playing games at the highest level and winning championships in the American League and, doing what he does best. But he's a big staple of our team, and he's a big reason for our success as of late, and we just need him to keep going.
In roster moves, the Rochester Americans have recalled forward Justin Danforth, and the Clones are set to welcome back Václav Karabacek into tonight's lineup.
Yeah, obviously it's always tough to lose a guy like Danforth, but he definitely deserves it to go up and get his chance up in at the American League, and we wish him the best. For Václav coming in today, he's been out for a while, but he's been training extremely hard, and he's ready to go, and he's been chomping at the bit to get back in the lineup and then show us that he's ready to go for the last stretch here of this regular season, and we're going to need him. We need him to step up right now and keep it simple, but play a strong game, and I know he's ready for the challenge in front of him. Well, it's just like we talked about earlier, we need everybody stepping up right now, but it's our puck management, and we got to make sure the other thing is just protecting our house. If we're going to give up shots, we'll keep them to the outside that, we know that our goalies can make those saves. But we don't need to be putting any high-risk plays up through our middle. And, just playing a sound game defensively will always gives us a lot of success. So that's the biggest thing for us, is just being good on the defensive side of pucks.